real treat for you today.
Thank you.
You're not unleashing Ted, are you?
Yeah, we're bad, we're bad.
Look at him. Never seen him move so fast.
He's keen to get fishing, isn't he? So we got special permission?
Special permission to fish this bit of old Father Thames.
Wow! Look at the mill, it is an actual mill. I mean, we are only a few inches from town.
You're a couple of yards from London.
Yeah, but it feels like we're in the middle of nowhere. I love it, Paul.
Look at Ted making himself
Ted, you can't go on the boat, son. Well, let's get to it, Paul.
Yeah. Oh, look, he looks a bit forlorn, look.
Oh, sorry, Ted.
Oh, sorry, Ted. You're down low there, Bob.
Yeah, you gotta keep low.
I tell you what, it's like you're reenacting Verdun or something like that.
I did once recreate the scene from Zulu, you know, for an advert.
What, just on your own?
No, we had army people.
Yeah.
There was a ranger with us to help us with the snakes and that.
Some people are terrified of snakes. Are you?
My wife's terrified of them.
Yeah. The spider and the snake are the two probably the most frightening.
Oh, no, they're not. The bear is.
I'm much more frightened of a bear than a spider. But I bet most people would pick spiders or snakes.
Well, you've got a choice to go into a room. Room A's got a spider in it. Room B has got snake. And yep. Room C has got a grizzly bear in it.
Well, I'm not going in room C. I'll take my chances in room A and B, spider and snake.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you bring your boat in, please? If you come to me, that'll be great, thank you.
Yeah.
I think this bloke on the bank wants us to come in, Paul.
Oh, no, look at him, look. Yeah, all right, we're coming.
You've got permission to fish here, haven't you?
Yeah.
Hello, sir. I'm from the Environment Agency. If you could bring your boat in, we're just doing a rod licence check if we may, please.
Oh, rod licence.
Have you got
sir.
One, Bob?
Yes, thank you.
Bob, have you got a rod licence?
Well, I am praying I have, yeah. I've got my Toby Carver ego card.
There you go, sir.
Ah, do you get a lot of trouble with people?
We can do, but for the most, they're pretty good. Would you mind signing your licence in front of me, please?
Oh, Bob, you haven't signed it. That's a contravention of Rule 42, Clause 16. Fine him, please.
There we go, sir.
Right, I'm quite chuffed to have been checked, to be honest. Thank you for doing it.
No, you're welcome.
Thank you for coming to my refresher course in meditation.
It is, you're a bit Yoda there. Oh, the Thames.
You seem a little bit excitable. You need to shake that out.
Like that.
There you go. Yeah. Just calm down. We're on the River Thames.
Yeah, I know. And what a treat.
What a treat.
That's Jules Holland, isn't it? And what a treat, ladies and gentlemen.
What a treat, yes.
What a treat. Bob.
Yes, my darling.
You look like a little Buddha there.
Yeah.
You've got the proportions right. But look to your right for enlightenment, look.
Are we fishing here?
Yes. The Thames Weirpools have got a magic of their own, Bob, you know, and especially here.
Oh, this is great, isn't it?
We're hoping to get perch.
Yeah.
Using a method called paternostering. The thing with a paternoster is, right, the float leads down to that, which is anchored on the bottom, and our bait is suspended above it. Okay.
Casual as that.
Yeah.
That will find the bottom because it's a floating float.
Yeah, it's a sliding float. Yeah. So we'll just leave that like that. Okay, and that's fishing already. Good lad, Ted. Hey, all right, mate. Oh, it's... Oh. You've won me round with cake.
Pocket plates.
Yeah, I really wanted you here, Pocket. Whoa, pocket plates.
Get in there.
You've come on, haven't you? Brilliant.
There you go, Paul.
Thank you very much.
Can you shift over a bit, Ted?
I'll do all right, son.
Yeah, I know you will, but...
It's my recliner. All right.
You smelt something, haven't you, Teddy? Have you had a nice steak?
Lovely, thanks. We don't get any better than this.
Mm.
But yeah, tomorrow we've got to get a big perch box. All right, Teddy is a good boy.
Did you hear him last night walking around the house?
Yeah. Doing his trombone, wasn't he?
He did a bit of that, yeah. But did you hear what he was saying over and over again?
What?
He was just crying, "Where's my briefcase?"
Yes.
"Where's my briefcase?"
"Where's my briefcase?" "You muppet." Oh, come on, Ted, you can do it. Come on,
go
mate.
Go on, Ted, go on, son.
Go on, son.
Whoa. Go on, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I hope you find it, Ted. Shall we have some like really uplifting morning music, but listen to it miserably to get us in the mood?
Can do.
Okay.
There you go.
Right, that's got us in the mood, Paul. Come on. All right, thank you very much. Hey, since we've been up this morning, Paul, we've complained about hips, knees. Yeah.
Tell you where to start, toenails.
My toenails?
Yeah, your toenails.
Well,
what
they're getting...
What are they like, Bob? I dread to think.
They're getting very thick.
Are they?
Yeah, I can't really get the scissors through them. I have to use a bread knife to start.
The bread knife,
to get a start.
Get the purchase on.
Yeah.
Right, moving up, the calves.
My calves are sweet, and I have got good, very good calves because
I've. Yeah, you've got good legs, Bob.
Because I've got restless leg syndrome.
What's that mean?
Where you get this tingling, it's like a feather's tickling your shin bone at the back.
Oh,
and
right.
So I do that all night.
Do you?
Yeah.
All night.
And I've built up really nice calves because of that.
Oh, right, okay. So night exercises.
Yeah.
What about your knees?
Knees pretty good.
The frontal area, any problems?
Front private. Mm. I mean, Max Harrison.
Yeah. Your Seve Ballesteros.
I'm cooking your feta cheese.
Whoa, feta cheese?
Aye. You know, it's not necessarily heart healthy, but of the cheeses, feta cheese.
And it's a lot healthier than gorgonzola.
Aye. So I hope you'll enjoy it.
Yeah,
we've got butter beans with it, spinach, lemon, garlic.
That's healthy, isn't it, Bob? You can't get much healthier than that.
Ted, I tell you what an honour it is to have you here.
Yeah.
But more especially, Ted's really showing up.
He really has.
Look, hasn't he? He's turned it on for the occasion.
I thought I'd wear a suit and look good, and then...
Well, you look good, but Ted's off the scale.
I know, it's ridiculous.
You know, it's like having George Clooney around, doesn't it?
You've got to get yourself familiar with your knackers.
Men are obsessed with everything down there and talk about it all the time, but they don't
genuinely engage with it.
No, so it's just thinking, oh, I'll leave that, I'll let that go.
Yeah.
And there's loads of things it can be that aren't as bad as cancer. So you might as well just go and get it checked out, and then you're not worrying about it.
In the days of Zoom appointments with the doctors, would you just have to press it against the screen? So I suppose you would. Is that what you'd have to do?
You're trivialising it now, Robert.
No, I'm just wondering. Right, thank you so much.
No, thanks, guys.
Richard, that's really brilliant.
Thank you.
Yeah, very interesting, enlightening, and sort of uplifting as well.
Good, yeah. I'd love to stay, but I've got to, you know.
What have you got to do?
I've got stuff to do. I've got to put the kids to bed.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Right. See you, Richard.
See you
very much. That was a nice one, Bob.
That was very interesting. Been a great trip, Paul.
Look at us, the three musketeers.
Yeah.
Isn't it? Has been a great trip, Bob.
I mean, I know I was a little bit,
you know, down on the fact we didn't get a big perch.
Yeah.
But more than that, really, it's a beautiful place.
Beautiful place, and we've treated ourselves, haven't we? Which you have to do once in a while, I suppose.
Once in a while, we have, haven't we?
We've had wines, we've had beers, we've had butter beans.
Oh, that was... Yes, I mean, there's a yin and a yang, isn't there?
We've got time for one final evening fish.
That'd be lovely, wouldn't it, Evan?
You going to join me?
Yeah.
You can bake me up.
I'll bake you up, son.
Oh! How glorious.